turn, and nice lobby, and you've got someone dolly well. This guy's got a tricky spot. Deepest player. I would have thought Andy in the second server, so it keeps you in the same spot. Ball. And you won't be going down the middle. Play the percentage shot. Don't need to go pretty risky. It's a non-volley, deepest player, isolate her, deeper with this player. Yep, beautiful. Nice shot down the middle, beautiful. I'd be keeping it away from him and just letting her. Take your time with the serve. Nina goes through the middle every single time. You want to keep your unforced errors down to absolute minimum. So go through the middle and go to feet. Great return and great return, and you would have got to the non-volley line. Because he's curving it to your backhand, make sure it would probably preload to the left hand side of the box if I was you. He wants to swing it around you. Again, I would go through the middle. You'll get as much value through the middle, or almost as much value through the middle without risk as you will going for lines. But nice. Doing a good job both getting to the non-volley line. Setting up to left hand side of the box to serve Nina, so the ball, any ball that comes back to you is going to only come back to your forehand. So where you are now there on the box, I'll be right to the left of that box. So you're loading your forehand for the next shot back. Excellent work, and getting some non-volley. Great point. Again, I would probably go down the middle. Just reduces the chance of any errors. But nice drop hand in that last shot. You got in, and then you can control the point. Yeah, we don't practice our serve nearly enough. But particularly in the room, like, make sure you do enough serve. Straight serve to the backhand. Could have volleyed that. If you'd volleyed that, you would have taken time away from them and you wouldn't have hit the step back. You guys are going well. I would just be hitting through the middle now into her. Again, both of you could be left hand side of the box there. You'll never come to your backhand like that one could. Nina, if that had gone in, that would have been to your backhand. Yep. Again, if you're on the very left-hand side of the box when you serve, less likely he's able to return it to your backhand. Good hand, isolate her. Down the middle is fine. Isolate her. Keep her back. Yep. She should have just dropped that into the kitchen. That was way below the net and she tried to attack. He's going to slice this. It's going to go to your backhand. Yep. Good. Great work dominating the net. Unlucky. See how he did that serve then? Swung into your backhand. I'd almost slide across before he served. Beautiful, leave the outballs. Love leaving outballs. Maybe it's my favourite shot to give them. My guess is, as this guy, if you isolate her, as this guy gets further into the game, he's going to try to go for more. Because he'll need to. Right idea. He's on him. I'm going to probably try to come in and dominate a bit more because she's clearly the weakest link. Nice serve. Yep. Good. Good, good, good. Again, if I'm getting the habit of hitting at feet rather than down the line or through the middle, the performance is away from him through the middle. He comes in, see where he is, he's right in the middle of the court. He's now wanting to dominate because he's realising you're isolating her. Every now and then you could put one down the line behind him just to keep him honest and back on his side of the court. Great service. The point, he had to be desperate and go for a winner down the line. Good, you're keeping it away from him, moving while playing the point, playing the shot, try and split step. Drop shot is a risky shot, but the people are slow. Otherwise, you just keep pumping it back to them. See that ant? He's curving it to your backhand. Oh, good lead. So he's going to try and go for winners because he has to now. Drop it into the kitchen and he can't attack it.